Hey guys, GetLevel here, and today I have something pretty special for you. I'm gonna be taking a look at a piece of hardware and software that might be a game changer for the live streaming world. Okay, so the big disclaimer here is that everything you see in this video is subject to change. I have access to this very early on, so there's a lot of things that are going to change in the future when they actually make it out to the public. But for now, we are going to be taking a look at some features of the Loop Deck Live. So the Loop Deck Live is one of many Loop Decks that they have, but this one has a more focus on live streaming. In the box, you will find the user's manual, the Loop Deck, you will find a little stand, and also a USB-C cable. So it's USB-C to USB-C, but they give you an adapter that converts USB-C to normal USB 2.0, 3.0. So that's what we're gonna use to plug it into our computer. Now, first impressions that I have of this is we don't have knobs. You know, when we talk about live streaming and stuff like that, there's now three things that I can name. The first one is going to be Touch Portal. That's on strictly on your mobile devices, so you're using the touch screen on your mobile. And then we have the Elgato Stream Deck, of course, where you actually have buttons that you can press. So that feeling of pressing buttons is it's kind of exclusive to the Elgato for now, especially buttons that have screens behind them. And now with the Loop Deck Live, the idea of being able to have knobs, have buttons, and having a touch screen that is separated, so when you're pressing a button, it doesn't feel as weird as pressing buttons on the tablet, because you really feel that you're pressing the specific button. It's great. And the cool thing with those knobs is that you can feel each level. So if you're trying to bump up your volume or stuff like that, we'll get into it. Anyways, let's plug it into the computer and see what it's all about. So they sent me a video preview, and I have to realize that I actually used the wrong part of the USB. I'm not supposed to put that part here. This is the part that's supposed to go in the PC. But anyways, this is what it looks like when you first turn it on, when you first plug it in. You have that pretty cool wallpaper with the Loop Deck logos. And then we will open up the software and see what it looks like. Okay, so immediately this is the first thing that we see when we turn on the software. The Loop Deck comes alive and gives you a bunch of information. This is already impressive, like the fact that it can tell you what time it is, it can tell you what volume your computer is at, no matter what software you're using. This is very useful. And then you have a pre-made profile for just Windows where you can just tap once and have Explorer turn on. And I don't know if you could hear that, but there's a little vibration when you press the touch screen, because like those aren't buttons, those are this is a touch screen. But the cool thing is that with the vibration, you can really feel when you pressed a button or if you didn't. You can open up your settings in the middle here. You can go to like a different screen, you can come back to that screen. There's a lot you can do. Okay, so top left, you'll see, well, just left, you will see this side, and then on this side, there's a little bit of the screen, but this is not necessarily used as a touch part. It is mostly used to display information. It tells you what those are binded to. So top left, I know that this wheel is actually going to be my desktop volume, and I can turn that, and it's super precise because you can really feel each step. We will see that later on you can actually bind that to your like mic audio or your desktop audio inside of your live streaming software, which is so cool. And then you have the wheel, so if you want to scroll down some stuff, for example here in Windows, if I want to scroll, I can do that using this. On a website, whatever you're doing that requires scrolling, you can do that. And this is just the default profile. Now on the software side, we have a preview of what everything looks like already. And to the right, let's go top right. Top right here is where you would log in. Right now, I do not have the ability to log in with this version of the software, but mine is beta. Remember, yours will probably be absolutely different. You have application and device. Device is going to be automatic, actually. It should pick it automatically, or you can just choose which Loop Deck that you have. And then application, this is where you can find what are you using it for. You know, those are the profiles for for the different apps. Right now, we only have Windows. Now, once you load up the profile, you will come here and it will tell you basically the different parts of the loop deck that you want to see what is bounded to, or if you want to customize them. So if I click on round buttons, this is the bottom part. As you can see, the first button that is green is for application. So if I press that, it will bring me to a menu with all the applications that I can immediately turn on. And I can press that round button here to go back to the main screen, okay? And then we know that 5 is space, 6 is delete, back, and then left windows. Let's try left windows. Boom. Round buttons is kind of like the main thing to open up some pages. I feel like it's gonna be the most useful thing. If you wanna go, like, if you have a soundboard or if you want to control Spotify, this is where I feel like you should put those shortcuts, basically. And then we have touchscreen pages. So you have this page. You can also add new pages, unlimited amount of pages. But right now, this is showing us the main touchscreen. And you can see this emoji thing. I didn't know that Windows had that. Apparently, yeah, there's an emoji keyboard on Windows. I had no idea that existed. This is gonna be the main page. From here, you can click back to go back to the display. But then you can click on dial pages. And dial pages is, of course, the knobs that you can turn. And you can see that each knob has two main functions. Basically, there's the one that's going to be the rotate action. So you can add an action to what does it do when I rotate it, and you can actually press them. So those are not just knobs, those are also buttons. So if you count 7 buttons here, 12 main buttons here, plus 6 additional buttons on each knob, which allows you to give an action for scrolling and also pressing a button. In this case, for example, it's muting my desktop audio and then lowering or increasing the volume. Another cool thing is that those side screen, I thought they didn't do anything until I double tap them and realized that they actually do have some function. This doesn't show anywhere on the version of the software that I have, but they do things, okay? They do things. Okay, and then under applications, you have the same thing. This is the application screen. So when you press 1, you're gonna have applications. And then from here, you can set a whole new world, a whole new world of macros or shortcuts and stuff like that. Now let's talk about customizing. Now, since most of my audience are live streamers, I'm not necessarily gonna go too in depth into, because there's so much things you can do. Right when you click on application, you can see all the apps that it already has profiles for and also specific actions for. I'm gonna open up Streamlabs OBS and show you basically what kind of blew my mind when I used this for the first time. So from the app, let's load up Streamlabs OBS. So this is the main profile that you have. So if you wanna quickly see what is already pre-installed, again, you can click round buttons, and this is where you control the stream, the studio mode, Spotify, Twitch itself, and then the three other buttons is to create a clip, create a marker, run a commercial. Those are preloaded with the software that I had, which is amazing because I didn't need anything else. Okay, so those are the round buttons. Now, if I go to touchscreen page, you will see here that we have a bunch of other options. So I can see all the options that I have: system commands, scene, sources. This is go live. This is record. You can put chat in slow mode. I believe this is create a clip, toggle playback, mute, everything. Okay. So many things. This is just for the stream version. And then for the dial page, for example, here, we can set it so that we control the desktop audio or something like that, which will bring us to the left side, the left panel, the actions. This is where you can set up everything. It usually is kind of dynamic, so it shows you pretty much what you already want to know. Just because we have the Streamlabs profile loaded, it's gonna show me Streamlabs OBS actions already. You can set scenes, you can control audio, you can control audio per scene if you want to. You can put streaming commands, toggle stuff, and of course you can create your own macros. You can create your own custom commands. And then we have rotation adjustments. This is where we're gonna find the audio, for example, the desktop audio for starting soon. I can click here and then drag this to this knob, okay? And then preset action is automatically going to be mute if I press the button. Now, the second most important one is the mic, boom. And now if you go to Streamlabs OBS and I start turning those, you can actually see my desktop audio. This is a game changer. This is a game changer because, to my knowledge, you cannot do this with any controller without like splitting your audio and using like a very complex method of virtual cables and all of that. This is already so cool. Now, the cool thing is that since there's Spotify integration, I don't have Spotify on this computer, but since there's Spotify integration, you can also bind it to turn down Spotify, right? You can play, pause, you know, next track. You can even add to playlist. If you were playing a random playlist and you like a song, you can press a button to add it to the play. There's so many things that I don't even know if I can put all of this in one video. Of course, you can switch scenes. You can play around with so many things. Let's go to stream. This is the main. And right now in my version, the reason why I press that lock thing is because it switches automatically depending on which app is in focus. But since we're live streamers, you know, if you're playing a game, you don't want the profile to switch. So you just lock it and then boom, this profile is set. So we can click on Spotify and check this out and then see everything that's here. And then we can find all the actions that are already available for Spotify. Change repeat state. You can press a button and make it shuffle. You can start a specific playlist. You can save to playlist. It's so much and it's so amazing. Spotify adjustments for the playback. You can like navigate track by turning the knobs and of course the volume. Let's check out Twitch. So here we have a couple of settings for Twitch. One thing to note is that, again, this is a beta, so everything like the icons that you see and stuff like that, those are not final. They will look better once the product is done, but also you will have the ability to customize your icons. For now, the only way that you have to customize the icon is if you create your own macros, your own custom commands, but in the future they let me know that you will be able to do all that. And again, if I want to create an action here, for example, let's say that I want to add a button that brings me to the intermission. So good, here I would go to scenes and then I would just drag and drop intermission here, and now it's updated. So if I press intermission, I have my intermission scene. This is so cool. This is so cool. It's annoying because the C920 is not doing this justice. This looks absolutely great. Hopefully, like, the shots from my other camera will look better. But this looks clean. This looks super clean, which is a shame that we can't, that I can't at least customize my own buttons right now, because I already wanted to put my own GIFs and all of that. And yeah, I really, really love the display, because information is just what we really want. Instead of having just, you know, you press a button and it glows or whatever, we have more than that. And they have compatibility with so many other software that I feel like this is what sets it apart from everything else, from Touch Portal or even the Stream Deck that I have here, is the ability to not only display information, turning knobs, pressing buttons, and pressing a touchscreen with a little vibration feedback, which you can customize, by the way. If you want the vibration to be longer or shorter or harder, that sounds weird, but it is something that you can customize in the settings, and it's overall, it's great. My mind is kind of blown, I'm not gonna lie. I feel like after they updated the software, this will definitely be a game changer. And like the feel, it's a little heavy. It feels great. So this is like the little stand. You can get rid of that if you want it to stay flat on the desk. But yeah, its main thing is that it's way more complex than a simple Stream Deck. I was kind of overwhelmed by the UI the first time I turned it on. So I was like, oh my God, there's a lot going on here. But it is because, you know, you have those separate things. So you need to customize every separate thing. So I haven't even taken the time to customize it because the preloaded profile, the preloaded presets were already so good. But that being said, if you were to customize this, this could be like a very good productivity booster, like really, really practical in that sense, especially if you're not only using it for live streaming, but also if you're doing photo editing, if you're doing video editing. I'm definitely going to try to bind a couple of things in Adobe Premiere. I've already done that with my Stream Deck. Hopefully like this will work well, but like the simple fact of being able to turn the knobs and press buttons is great. It's already so cool. So my final verdict for the Loop Deck Live is that it's an awesome piece of hardware and software. The possibilities are really endless, knowing that you can customize it like to no end, really unlimited pages and actions and stuff like that, including macros and multi-actions, and you can add delays and stuff. It's great. It's already so cool with all the things that are preloaded, the presets. So I can't even imagine if you come up with your own stuff. Yes, I'm a big fan of just being able to turn down my volume manually. I'm such a huge fan of that, and I really, really hate doing it software-based. I hate using virtual keyboards. I really do not like having to separate my audio through software and having to mess with it through software. So this actually helps out a lot, and depending on the software that you're using and the compatibility, this is like a mixer too, which is crazy. I mean, it's compatible with Ableton, whatever. You can do music with this. This is also a MIDI controller. Anyways, I'm so happy that they sent me this. I'm not being paid, by the way. They just sent me this sample, and then they gave me a beta of the software just to know how I feel about it, and I feel pretty good. I'm not gonna lie, I kind of like it a little bit more than my Stream Deck, but like, of course, I don't get the main button press feel that I have this Stream Deck. So if I were to recommend you anything, is that really think about how you use your own software. Basically, if you need some turning knobs, if you need, you know, main buttons, but also the touchscreen will do, if you need actual information to be displayed on a tiny little screen in front of you, then the Loop Deck might be for you. But I think in if you have both of them, I think it's like the perfect setup, because you have the main basic stuff if you want to press stuff, if you want to activate stuff, but you can use the Loop Deck to tweak stuff, for example, if you want to control Spotify and stuff like that. But both of them can do it, so it's hard to compare them, because I feel like you wouldn't use them for the exact same purposes. It really depends on your own workflow. Anyways, I'm gonna stop rambling. My mind is kind of blown, and that's not really a review, because this is not the final product, but this is my take so far on the Loop Deck. It has immense potential. As it is right now, it's already amazing, but the potential of this being even better in the future is a game changer. It has to be, like, I don't see it as anything else than a game changer. We're finally seeing MIDI controller technology come to live stream with actual compatibility and integration, and that's amazing. The overlay pack that you saw me use in Streamlabs OBS is actually available right now at gumroad.com/gallevel. You can get it for yourself. And then, you know, the rest, follow me on social media, click subscribe for more videos like this one. And if you want any more info on the Loop Deck, it will be in the description below. Join the Discord if you have any questions, or if you just want to hang out or meet maybe 1,000 other streamers. And I will see you guys next time. Thank you so much for watching. Go out there, make me proud. Get level out.